Welcome back. We're glad you're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Now, I did tell you last week that the whole of this month we'll be celebrating women in business. And last week we did celebrate a young lady that after campus chose to venture into a personal business. She is dealing in shoes. Yes, she actually makes them in Mukono. And this week we want to celebrate Natasha, who is the CEO and co-founder of WAPE Africa's digital talent marketplace. Now, this is an e-commerce platform that is trying to link up buyers and the business community. Time saving again. Plus, just how, you know, with ease can you access your commodities now? She tells us she is doing this and she is actually making some money. Let's run you through how to make money.
My name is Natasha Katwandrachi. I am an entrepreneur, a co-founder and the team lead at WAPE. WAPE is a digital talent marketplace that matches global companies and employers to take and creative talent from Africa in less than 7 days. So that means we have a talent pool of software engineers, graphics designers, UI, UX, digital marketers. We vet and profile them and then match them to these opportunities in Africa and beyond. We started WAPE to create a platform where young people that have digital skills can access meaningful earning opportunities without biases of age, gender, or what academic qualifications they have, but basically the digital skills that they have accessed over time. And along the way, we also realized that there are so many upskilling programs that are currently going on, but few solutions for what happens after these people have gotten those skills. So WAPE is then the solution to help the people that have gained these skills to then leverage those skills to access meaningful learning opportunities globally. We leverage a lot on technology and digital spaces. So the digital spaces has definitely created a global network virtually where we even have people here, software engineers that are working for our clients in Europe, and they do all this work, you know, remotely, and they're able to thrive in their workplaces. So we leverage on the power of the internet, the power of, you know, the global network to be able to engage these clients and then, you know, show them the solution that they can actually hire tech talent from Africa, and these people can be able to add value onto their businesses. Even our talent pool, most of it is remote. Of course, we've had a few community events where we have our talent come in, you know, and we get to engage with them. But from the point of onboarding to the opportunities that they are matched to, everything is pretty much remote. So we are basically leveraging the power of the internet and remote connection on the web. I think the status quo in the past was because of, you know, the cost of internet in Uganda, but also our exposure. It had been in the rabbit hole in the past, but I would think now that we can now start to see the light at the end of the tunnel. People are more exposed, people are more cognizant of the fact that, you know, like about half of the jobs that will be there in the next 30 years are not there now. So they are curious and wondering, what skills do I then need to know in order to be relevant in the next, you know, 10 years? Upskilling programs have come up, institutions are training people in programming skills and data science and all these relevant things that are going to be mostly relevant in the next coming years. So I think we haven't gotten to where we are meant to be, but I would think we're better than where we were 25 years ago, where, for example, women were not having phones, or even the coverage of phones was way smaller. I think we're getting there. E-commerce can be made a big thing, starting with the basic fundamentals, right? The basics are that we need access to the internet, equitable access to the internet for both men and women. Internet needs to be accessible. Mobile phones should be affordable for all people, because you will start by accessing a mobile phone and then you get, you know, data, and then you get access to the internet, and then that's how you'll know that I don't have to go maybe to town to do shopping. I can go to an e-commerce platform and get something. I can advertise my business on an e-commerce platform. So I think it starts with things like access to the tools that we need before we can then get to that, you know, e-commerce platform. We definitely are still on the lower I would say the technology minority in regards to gender, honestly, because right now if you look at the tech space, men cover about, you know, more than 70% of the, and the women are the smaller percentage. But like I shared earlier, there are so many things that are happening right now to empower these women. One of the fundamental objectives as to why WAPI was started was to create an inclusive platform where people can earn meaningful, you know, earning opportunities and biasless access to earning opportunities. And every day in our operations, we're encouraging women that, hey, no one cares if you're a woman. Learn the skill. If you have value that you can add to a company through your tech skills, there is an opportunity and we can match you to it. And we are still the minority in the tech space, but there are more, you know, women tech groups now, institutions training women in technology skills, and people are getting more work. The gender is getting work, and we'll definitely be able to get there. I think most of the challenges for companies that have started and are probably at their stage of funding, there's a big issue with funding, and that's mostly because of bias of funders against Ugandan founders because of the size of the economy that we are in and so many other factors, right? But I am proud to say that despite those challenges, Ugandans are now, you know, getting inspiration from the companies that have gotten funding in East Africa and in Africa. Innovations are coming up every now and then, but also most importantly, we have seen the light and we know that entrepreneurship without innovation now does not really solve problems, and we know better. So hopefully in the coming years, it will be much better than it is.
So there you have it, and you can only be sure that the subsequent weeks too will be celebrating more women that are trying to create a difference in this country and the world of business generally. Let's talk about personal finance tips for this week. Just the basics that you need to run yourself, your personal finances and the finances of your business.
Hello, my name is Enoth Mbeine. I'm the CEO of Make Business Consult and also a mentor, a business coach, and a lecturer for entrepreneurship. I'm happy to be with you here this evening. Last week, we covered on how not to mix your personal issues with your business. And this week, I'm glad to share with you a very interesting discussion on why small business owners should be financially literate. And I would call this financial literacy for small business owners. What is financial literacy? Basically, financial literacy is being able to understand the dynamics or the finances of your business. Many of us small business owners don't take it seriously to be able to understand what finances are and how the finances are doing for our business. So, as small business owners, I would like to urge you to take very keen interest in learning more about your finances, learning more about finances for your business. Otherwise, over time, we have seen when small business owners don't take keen interest, problems happen, money is stolen, and the company ends up closing. So small business owner out there, please, it's extremely a very important issue to understand the finances of your business. How do you do this? First and foremost, aim at keeping accurate books of accounts. And nowadays, there are all these softwares, QuickBooks. Come up with a good package that can help you to keep accurate books of accounts. And here you'll be able to easily pay your statutory obligations, you'll be able to pay your workers, you'll be able to pay your suppliers if you have accurate book of accounts. The other issue as a small business owner is you need to go an extra mile to be able to learn about these finances and the financial issues. I always like this course that is always advertised, Finance for Non-Finance Managers. Go for it. Go and study about it. Study more about finances. What's the balance sheet? What is the cash flow? What is the ledger? All these things are extremely important for you to understand. As a small business owner, you also need to track and frequently review your financial statements. I was a culprit in this particular scenario where I took a lot of time without checking on my financial statements. And one of my my bookkeeper took advantage of this. I also give you another example of another company that I know very well, where the business owner was not tracking their finances all the time. And the bookkeeper or the accounts assistant would always collect this money and doesn't bank it. And as we speak now, the company is closing and he's battling this in court with this finance assistant. But the damage is already done. He's regretting he should have done a periodical check on his financials. So small business owners out there, please, it's extremely important for you to always review. You can do it on a weekly basis, you can do it on a bi-weekly basis, or you can do it on a monthly basis. Then also, when the business starts growing and the transactions become complex, then there, I think it's incumbent upon you as a small business owner to hire services of a qualified accountant, if you can afford, or even a bookkeeper. So here you're able to professionally keep your books of accounts. That's if the business is now growing, you know, from a smaller business, now it's growing, the transactions are becoming many. It's okay. Hire the services of a qualified bookkeeper. Then also constantly as a small business owner, check on your cash flows. Check on your expenses. Here it will be able to help you. What's going out? What's going in? Okay? And lastly, as a small business owner, for you to be able to keep track with the finances of your business, keep track of the changing market trends in your company. Things might be changing, the prices. Look, read around, invest in time to learn more, because you might be relying on a certain technology. You might be relying on buying products from a certain supplier, and then there's a new supplier who's going to offer these products on a cheaper basis. So look out for the trends in the market, the changes in the trends in the market. So small business owner out there, please, it's very, very important to understand the basics of finances for your small business. Good luck.
So to the Forex now, and looks like the shilling has been holding relatively stable through the start of the week to today, and we can hope that this keeps on. The comprehensive report is here now for you that is looking to trade across the different major currencies. Alright, so before we go, let's just take a look at the business quote for this week. And it says, brands mature over time like a marriage. That's interesting. It depends on who is listening, because some marriages might just not mature over time. But look, if you're a business person and you have your brand, you do not think it's going to break through overnight. Sometimes we look at these brands that are made it and we ask ourselves, what are some of the things they do? I have heard people talk about, there's a particular brand from South Africa, I think, that has one of the best adverts in this country, I should say, or in the space of business. But if you sit back and ask yourself just how long it took them to get it to this point where you can sit back and say they have the best adverts okay, like well thought adverts. And then there's you that is starting your business, and the first 2 years you want to break through with your brand. I am not saying you can't break through. You can actually break through in the first 1 year with your brand, and boom, it's all over the place and everyone knows it, yeah? But it's important for you to understand that these things take time. Get the basics right. Keep doing the same thing right, and your brand will shoot out there over time. Like some successful marriages, your brand will matter and it will break through. My name is Simon. Feel free to get in touch with us. Listen, tell us what you like about the Business Show. And for those of you that look for more information, you can check out our New Vision website, yes, for the latest business info. Also, on the morning show, Rush Hour, there's always updates on the business segment from 7:15 to 7:30 every weekday. So make a date with us and learn something about how you can improve your business. My name is Simon. Until then, you take good care of yourselves. Keep watching Urban. More programs coming through. And from me and the team, it's bye-bye. We'll see you soon.